see it, it's going to be there they miss. Yeah. So I believe that we start. And let me introduce now our next speaker. This is Ms. Kazuhisa Jima, world most famous architect. And from our point of view, we are very proud to host her today. And she's, we also hope that one day the project that Mr. Jima is talking about, will be talking about today, will be become a part of Skolkovo. And for those of you who do not know Mr. Jima enough, you'll probably, you know, start asking for autograph after the section. So without no further ado, Mr. Jima and Mr. Matthias Schuller, the partner of Mr. Jima on the project Dome. It's a future part of Skolkovo, and basically it's a future city. It's something like a future city should look like and will look like. And if we can have a presentation now on, Julian, can we put it on the stage, on the screen now? The presentation? Yeah, it's coming. Yes. Okay.
So I start. Good morning. My name is Kazuhisa Jima, the Sana from Sana, Tokyo. And I'm now involved in the Skolkovo project, and I made a project with the Matthias Schuller. He is the climate engineer. And then today, this is a very important part, so that today, first I quickly explain our project, and then later he will explain from his concept. Maybe many people know already about the Skolkovo City project. This is a kind of the master plan phase, the model. And then you see, this is a project what we are doing now. The Skolkovo new city will sit the west from the Moscow, about 20, 30 minutes by car. And this is a kind of innovative city. And this showed some plan and also the center zone. There is the station, and then we make a Skolkovo entrance that together with OMA, this works for the center part of the city. The left hand, there is a techno park, and also there is a university park. And also,
that's the pointer, the green.
Thank you. Station, and then so that this our Skolkovo entrance is a kind of a connection between the whole city and the station. And about this project, the first I like to explain, this is a climate landmark for innovative city, and second is environmental buffer, and third is climatic concept engineering. These three parts we like to explain this project.
So basically, it's a very innovative concept, if you let me just to expand on that a little bit. So basically, the part of the project is also not only architecture, but also change the perception of the climate. And you know that climate is something that we miss here. We don't have good weather for 8 months out of the 12. And I hope that Mr. Jima will break through this bad karma and bring us the solution.
From now, this part. So this is a kind of the entrance park, and also we like to make a kind of landmark for the new innovative city. So you know, this is a kind of very famous the landmark. And then our Skolkovo Dome is, the height is 126.5 and diameter is 230 square meter. And in this project, we try to make a landmark, but this landmark is not sculpture or the object, but we try to make a kind of a space used by the people. And this landmark show the invisible, visualize the invisible climate. this is our concept, and this works as a kind of a new landmark of the new innovative city. And this is some image, is one image, is a site, and then we like to make a kind of soft buffer, and this works a kind of landmark, and also kind of space for the people. And this become a kind of entrance park, and to make a center zone for the new city. This is the, if you are arrived the station by train, and then from the station you will be invited to the, in the dome, there is a kind of the entrance, it is a kind of entrance park. And then you arrive the some plaza inside, and there is the, for example, the park, but also there are another art center or politics center or some cafe, and also many activities in this dome. And the interesting thing is that this is this space is not interior space, but also not outside space. This is a kind of a buffer between the inside and outside. And this space will be controlled by the natural energy. So that means we will not use air conditioning, but we try to use the sun energy and also the another energy, natural energy. This will be explained by the Matthias. And so that means that there is some building, for example, art center, but at the same time you can use full space of the in the dome. And then also some road pass in the dome, and then the people can transit to the electric car. And this is the art center, and then of course we will present the art or some work from the innovative city, but also we can use the outside, and the outside space is also the semi inside space, so you can use the whole space, and also we try to keep the nature as it is, so that there is some forest and also there is some wet space, and you can enjoy the sports or many things. And this is to show the existing forest and also wetland. And interesting, the very special thing is even the winter, we try to keep the energy from summer period and then try to keep in this dome as a kind of 5 degrees. So this is why I say that this is a buffer zone, and then you can use this, the between space as a whole year. Maybe from here, that Matthias will explain how to realize this situation.
Okay, so engineering-wise, we try to, in a certain way, thinking on this is where we are in Moscow, and in a certain way, we know 5 months of the year, it's quite cold.
Actually, so the intention is eight, to be honest.
Eight, okay.
Yes.
So we are trying to push from Sochi or from the Crimea Peninsula up to Moscow to create an interior space which in a certain way reflects the climate of the Krim in Moscow. So in this dome, in a certain way, by collecting the solar gains during summertime and storing the energy deep into the ground, we can in a certain way store this until the winter time and heat the space. So in a certain way, this is now in winter time where you have minus 25 extremely or minus 10 outside. In the dome will keep it always in the range between 5 and 10 degree plus. So that's why we have this inner green, permanent green below the dome, and we do it by, in a certain way, a floor heating system, but this floor heating system is, in a certain way, working with the energy we are collecting during the summertime. It's a quite transparent glass dome. It's a kind of a double glazing, high sophisticated envelope to ensure we are not losing too much energy during the cold period, and we are able to collect as much energy during the summertime. This is the kind of a geothermal system below the dome, below the foundation. This is where, in a certain way, we push the surplus heat into during the summertime. So this is, in a certain way, the concept. You take the heat in summer, you take it out of the dome. In summer, it really gets warm. And we know in Moscow, in summer, it gets quite warm. So in the dome, at the top of the dome, which is, by the way, 125 meter high, at the top of the dome, you will partially reach up to 40 degree. We're collecting this energy, we bring it into the ground, we store it, and in winter time we take it out of the ground to keep the ground, to keep the dome during that time of the year where there's not a lot of sun in Moscow. We can keep the dome at the temperature we typically had down in Sochi, where in winter it never goes below freezing. It typically stays between 3 and 4 degrees Celsius. So this is the summer concept, where the solar gains in a certain way will provide us the energy to collect for winter time. In addition, we are in a certain way, we are able to ventilate the dome, and we are creating, and that's in a certain way a nice feature, we are creating an artificial cloud in the dome. So to shade the space, we did detailed engineering analysis, how the air movement, how the temperature stratification will behave. You see, if you close the dome, you get quite high temperature at the top of the dome, but you can open it up and it ventilates. And this is the first artificial cloud we did in 2002 in Frankfurt. So this kind of cloud we're intending to have in the dome as, in a certain way, as a shading device. Some of you may have seen our cloud we did 2 years ago in Venice, where in a space, in this case a 7 meter high space, we had a floating cloud. You could walk through the cloud. So in this cold cover dome, you can experience by the observation tower this kind of temperature change and artificial cloud. So that's the, in a certain way, the mechanism to make this cloud happening indoor. As a kind of a thermodynamic example of the innovation hub, Skolkovo, in a certain way, Skolkovo Institute is intending to be on the market. So the view, if you go through the dome, you maybe once, you see on the right side, the 100 meter high observation tower where you could be standing on the dome, looking down on the cloud, which typically will be at a layer of whatever, 70 meter. We are just opening a big glass house in Singapore. This is the Garden by the Bay. This is only 80 meter high, it's not 125 meter high. But you can see a similar approach with this kind of mountains, with the artificial cloud hanging in the dome, kind of shading, protecting the dome from collecting too much heat during summertime. In a certain way, we are doing all of this in a certain way by the natural renewable energy we have. The dome surface is covered with a photovoltaic energy collection. So in a certain way, some of you may know from the train station in Berlin, there are solar photovoltaic elements in the building envelope which are collecting enough energy to be, in a certain way, stored in the envelope. And at the bottom of our base, we're intending to have the possibility to enter into the dome, but as well to create a kind of an airlock to ensure it's working as well at the extreme temperatures. So a kind of a final overview how this dome may look over the year. You see in spring it may be as transparent as possible, but then over the time of the year it's changing. But even in winter, when it's really cold and snowy outside, you will still have the green envelope below this kind of huge dome. And I think I'm giving back to Mrs. Seshima.
This is the last image. I like to conclude using these images. I say same thing again, but the for Skolkov Dome, that is the entrance for the Skolkov New Innovative City. And in there, I like to make a kind of landmark, but it's not the landmark of the object, but I like to make a space, and which always expressing the different condition of the climate. Normally the climate is invisible, but I like to make a space for the people to work at the center of the city. And this image shows always this is not interior space, but not outside space. This is a buffer between outside and inside. And this space a kind of integration with the nature and technology, new technology. And then always showing a different expression to the city and to the outside to work as a kind of landmark, and also I hope that all the year everyone, people can enjoy the real same interior outside space, and people feel very nature, and also people can feel also new technology. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Jima. So you see, the only problem now Skolkovo has, that the only thing that we miss comparing to Silicon Valley is the climate. And Mr. Jima, with her imagination and creativity, realized that right away and proposed as a solution. And I really hope that this whole thing is going to happen, even though it looks like a science fiction. It's actually possible with the engineering talent of Mr. Shule and his company to make it happen. So we now have an opportunity to ask questions, Mr. Jima and Mr. Shule, starting from, is it really going to work? And you know, tell us about how you came up with this idea, etc. So I'm opening the floor for discussion.
I just have a quick question for the architecture. Is it completely inspired by Etienne Louis Boulay? And are you challenging finally? Are you the first architect who finally realized Etienne Louis Boulay's dream? I'm asking if you're finally the first architect who succeed to realize in real the Etienne Louis Boulay dome. And if yes, what is the size compared to what Boulay wanted to do?
So for those of you who are not familiar with Etienne Boulay was the architect of the 18th century, if I'm not corrected, and that was his vision. So the question is it something related to the Etienne Boulay vision of the dome that he proposed to create, or is it something that was inspired by something else? So what was the inspiration for this concept?
This concept, the dome is the most, of course there is a dome already, but normally it's smaller, and also sometimes the baseball stadium, it's this size, but very low. But from the energy point of view, we need some height to have a different temperature to use a natural the wind power from the low part to go up, and also from a sculpture point view, that this also works very well. So it's very important for us. It's not object, the space, and also to use the natural energy to make a kind of a new type of space. It's not really outside, and it's not really inside. It's a buffer zone. And very good communication between the nature and the new technology. This is our concept, and then the shape is a kind of important, but at the same time also the collaboration with Matthias and also structural engineer, we come up with this idea.
So in a certain way, the dome represents the ideal form in the structural, way to cover such a big space. And I think the concept we are presenting is combining the sculptural expression of a dome with the structural optimization and the climate optimization. So this dome is not only a signal in respect of a space, but it kind of allows us to protect an partially indoor space and keep it at a temperature without, in a certain way, putting energy from outside in. We are collecting the energy during summertime, which we then spending in winter to keep this as a kind of separate space from the outside.
Do we have, we hope that we answered the question. If not, you can talk to Mr. Jima afterwards. So if anyone has a question to Mr. Jima, anything to do with them, okay, coming.
So am I right that you are trying to create something like controlled climate in such a large space?
Right, in a certain way, we are creating a climate, an indoor climate in Moscow, and that was the idea, and to certainly reflecting on the today or the standard climate in Moscow, where we know it's very cold in winter and very hot in summer, to say, okay, wouldn't it be nice to have Moscow down at the Crimea Peninsula? So we are allowing to collect during summertime the energy to provide this climate in wintertime. So you can walk in the dome in Skolkovo in wintertime at 5 degrees minimum outside, so the plants will survive, but you even can sit outside in the dome in the cafe and have your tea or your water kind of sitting outside, but looking outside where it's freezing cold and you see the snow.
And how are you going to, because there are supposed to be a lot of plants, a lot of green plants, how are you going to water them in the winter?
Okay, we are collecting, in this case, we are collecting the rainwater from the envelope. We have huge underground tanks where we store the rainwater from, in a certain way, the fall season. So we are able to water the plants in wintertime. We have enough. The envelope is like 100,000 square meters where we can collect the rainwater. And we parallel, like for the energy, we are collecting the water to ensure we can feed the plants during winter time.
Thank you.
How big is the area?
The dome has 125 meter radius, so the ground floor is like 50,000 square meters. 50,000 square meters is the area, and the dome surface is roughly 100,000 square meter. That's the envelope. And we talk about 4 million cubic meters of air, which are included in there. And I think you can imagine to be in this space, which is 125 meter high, the biggest, I think the biggest artificial dome built. And there will be an observation tower, so you can drive up with an elevator to a height of 100 meter and look down and look on the city of Skolkovo, on the whole technology.
And even Moscow, I think. And also, if you go up, you can have an experience to touch the different environment. For example, summer, is the lower part is 25 degrees. But if you go up and through the cloud, because cloud, sunny day, the avoid the sunlight coming down, and then go up, you feel very hot. But also, so you can enjoy also the different type of environment.
And I have a personal question. So it's going to be made of glass, right? The whole surface. And we also understand that it's, you know, it's a different type of temperature, different type of people that live around. So is it going to be bulletproof, or is it going to be like, how strong is going to be the glass? Is it going to be bulletproof?
Bulletproof. Depending on the quality of glass, you you're choosing. You can even do it bulletproofed. Typically, because it's an overhead glass, it will be laminated glass, two layers of glass laminated together. So if a piece of glass breaks, it doesn't fall down, it stays there. So that's a standard overhead glass technology we are using. I'm not sure if we have to, because that's a big question. If we need to have it bulletproofed, you can even do it bulletproof. So I think we haven't decided. We are at the moment in a kind of a concept phase. We are even looking at different technologies. There may be even an idea to do it as a cushion, as a foil cushion. Some of you have seen the Eden Dome in England, which is a cushion, a foil. So if you shoot it, it will be just a hole. So maybe that's something we have to consider in the choice of the technology.
And also another question we have.
Just wondering ahead of, just in terms of a future city, do you imagine this to be a potentially interesting site for residential community as a future? Can it house people in the dome?
How to use the dome? To live? You mean live inside? Uh-huh. But I think it is possible because we will make some building inside. I mean, I explained, for example, art center or the cafe or some more. But I think that I'm thinking this is more the public space. So I said the building, but the building doesn't, it's maybe become a special building because it doesn't touch outside the directory. There is some buffer, so maybe the building itself become different, I think, because some buffer behind. And also the inside the forest or nature, so I think I really is a kind of a big public space and the people creative personally how to use this the space. But at the same time, always many people can stay together.
And the other, I would say the other note or the other message out of the dome is in respect of the city of the future, that this dome will be operating carbon neutral. So we will not use fuels from outside. We collect the sun. Even in Moscow, there is enough sun, if you collect it during summertime, to in a certain way to temper such a dome in wintertime. I think that's a nice message, that even sometimes people would say in Moscow, there's not enough sun. During summertime, you have a lot of sun. The only point is you need the technology to store it. And I think that's as well a nice message for Skolkovo as an innovation hub, to say this dome makes the statement that we have the technology to collect the energy during summertime to feed even a glazed outdoor space for plants. So it shows like a statement, this is kind of how we have to live in the future of the city, in the city of the future, because we should live carbon neutral.
Exactly, and on this note, speaking about Skolkovo and saying how innovative we are and thinking that future people will live like plants in the glass houses, right? Just imagine that. I would like to thank all of you who came to this panel, and Mr. Jima and Mr. Schuller. And I believe that next panel is going to be here, and people are already waiting. So thank you very much. And let's round of applause.